Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Your Excellencies and distinguished guests, I am honored to be with you today at the Riyadh Global Digital Health Summit, organized by the Ministry of National Guard Health Affairs and hosted by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia as one of its G20 presidency associated events and in collaboration with the Saudi Center for International Strategic Partnerships. During the Kingdom's presidency of the G20 and prior to the emergence of the pandemic, we have introduced pandemic preparedness and digital health as key health priorities. The emphasis on digital health was critical as it plays a fundamental role in supporting health emergency management by strengthening existing response mechanisms. Digital tools also enable innovative, equitable access to health services, data sharing, and improve coordination. We in the Kingdom have capitalized on many of our existing digital applications that offer AI components in tackling this pandemic, some of which include the Central Appointment System, Mawid, which is an app that enables patients to book appointments with their doctors at primary healthcare centers, as well as managing their referral appointments. Total appointments that has been done so far in the past 2 years exceeding 50 million appointments. We also established a virtual medical consultation app, Saha, with an AI component that offers face-to-face consult interaction with medical professionals and can be used abroad by Saudi citizens and residents at no cost. We have also established drive-through testing capabilities, which can be booked electronically to enable individuals to conduct COVID-19 tests from their vehicles on the day of their choosing for their convenience. We have also developed a dedicated app, Tatamman, for individuals in isolation facilities, which provides direct and continuous contact with the patients to provide them with up-to-date health case information, as well to ensure their compliance with health regulations. We have also concentrated our efforts on safeguarding our healthcare practitioners by developing dedicated apps which allows them to share medical information and prescribe medications to patients remotely with no physical interactions to minimize the possibility of infection. We have also implemented virtual clinics and tele-ICU, which provides healthcare practitioners direct access to patients remotely. This has allowed for seamless communications with residents and nurses to consult virtually. Tele-rounds and remote consultations were also made possible through robotics, which safeguards healthcare professionals by minimizing physicians to COVID-19 patients' contact. Teleradiology has been expanded to cover COVID-19 designated hospitals. And medical protocols and guidelines are published online and are available via an app to ensure dissemination of information in a timely manner. These digital tools, along with the implementation of exceptional health and safety measures, have assisted us in successfully navigating what is typically one of the largest religious gatherings in the world under extraordinary circumstances. Pilgrims arriving in the holy cities were electronically tagged with bracelets designed to monitor and record their health status and track individuals quarantined upon their return home through the Tatamman app. And as a result, we have been very fortunate to have zero cases of COVID-19 during Hajj this year. These initiatives prove that digital health has and will continue to be the most effective tool in which we can ensure rapid response and delivery of efficient, safe, and effective care. The collaborative efforts exerted by all participants are showcased in the success of this momentous event and by the announcement of the Riyadh Digital Health Declaration, which leverages the role of digital technologies and innovations in our fight against COVID-19. And with that, please allow me to introduce His Excellency Dr. Bandar Al-Ghanawi, the CEO of the Ministry of National Guard Health Affairs. Thank you.